Hi everyone, welcome to a cruising vlog. As you can see, we're heading from Greenfield Lock down to Rocky. So we're just going past some more boats. So, I'm hoping I can do some filming of some locks. I'm doing this bit because I did film all the way to Starbridge. Bit narrow here. So, on the left. You see all the more boats. So this is part one of the next play. We're just sticking the canal.
No chef sugar.
This please.
I'm an egg.
Okay. So this boat on the right, not this one coming up, this one, I think it's a bucky boat just coming up. So this boat here is a butty boat, I think. So it's a working boat. So that, the Kickabucky boat, no
engine. Why you hang out last night? He rang me and he was so looking forward to sleeping on his boat and it being dark.
No television, he said. Yeah, well, fingers crossed for it. Yeah. Take care. So, as you can see, the chimney's set up on the bow of the boat. So, I think the fire's in.
Ready?
The fire in.
In your front?
Yeah. So we're coming up to Ashford Nurses Marina. It's about 3-4 minutes from where we are now. But put this way, it's only around the corner. And I'll just cut the corner. It's moving a bit further over to the right. So I'm going to let you sit here for a little potential cruise. So on the left, there is a little bit of a bank. You can probably pick it up hard. Camera. So where we're going is, we're going to get above the fort and I think we are stopping for dinner. That's when I will stop the vlog. that'll be the end of this vlog. So I'm gonna try and record all of this all the way down to Rocky, and then I'm gonna see if I can put you on the bow of the boat. So it's about half a mile to the lock. Not far really, but you. I'm not going very fast because it's cold, it's wet, and it's a little bit windy, breezy. But all in all, it's not too bad. So this could be the end of the cruising series for a bit. You need your wellies on the footpath. I'm coming up to a moored boat. So on the, I'm not sure if this is part of Ashwood Nurseries or not. There has been one boat going up or down, one going up and down I think. I'm not entirely sure. As you can see, the boat's just ahead. And there is a chimney. The chimney does need to come down. Lily at the bridge.
A motor in there.
I've only done one lock. So Ashwood Nurseries is to the left. So if you want to keep your turn, you would have to do probably a bit of reversing.
Yeah,
in this direction. If you were heading from the direction we were coming last time, you'd be, well, to be fair, it'd be tiny fun. If not great. Because, so Ashwood Nurseries is just to our left in a minute, but that's the bank, which you can't moor on. Quite dangerous, so you can only moor on, I'll show you in a minute, but the entrance is quite tight to get in. Classic nursery. Loads of more boats. I think yeah, you do have to pay to in there. I think it's quite expensive. You do do get electric at Marina, but on the side of the canal, don't. Quite a pleasant day, but cold. So there's the entrance, just there. But the only side you can moor on is this side just here. So we are heading towards the bridge. You can't drive on this one. There's more and more boats. To the left. Right, it's just a normal towpath. You can probably see on camera. I'm not entirely sure, but there is a bridge. I'm gonna have to slow down now. So we don't get. I think the ones on the left are permanent moorings, but I don't think you can moor here. But also, you can't fish. Either. So if you are looking at a cruiser, you will know a bit more. So if we go on the left, it's all sheltered up. But then we have a ton of boats from down. Well, we did when we moored up the other day, the night. We did have some boats, but we did get stuck. The bridge I do not like. I don't like this bridge.
I'll come and do that.
There we go, through the bridge. Nice gentle cruise. And also there is a nice garden. To the left of the boat. And there is a little friend. Four-legged friend. So heading on to Rocky, which is half a mile It's about at least 20 minutes to the lock. Pretty quick. And if it does rain, I will have to stop the recording. Some more boats just to the left. These aren't part of Ashford. These are just, I think they're private moorings. So I think this is a winding hole. No, it's not. It's not a winding hole. I will show you a winding hole in a minute. Well, when we get to one. And the next one is, I can't remember if it's below Gosher Slay or just above. I think it's below. We go past it to get to the Hillmorton Locks, I think. No, not Hillmorton. I can't remember the name of the four locks. There are some nice boats. I'm not too keen on the grey boat though. It's not very colourful. That looks like on a rainy day, that boat just goes out. Couple of more boats. Yeah. Coming out to the first of the lock, can't we? So here's the first lock. First lock. Second of the first lock for the camera. Yeah. I did film that, Green Sox. I'm gonna try and film you doing the lock. I'm gonna try and film you doing the lock, are ya? So I'm best play on the mooring. So putting it on the mooring. Yeah. We're gonna get the rope ready. No. We're too full. So you stick the boat in fairly soft reverse. Just to stop it drifting. That's how you stop the boat. I'm going. It will drift forward just a little bit. But I want to put. I am going to put the camera at the bow of the boat. A minute. Just to stop the boat drifting into the bank, I'll stick it in to a nice soft reverse. And you can see somebody's on the lock. Not very deep over there, so over here, I will show you the stern. That's the canal, it stops, this is the stern, and that's where we just came from. And that's the bank, the boat. I will show you the gears. So the gears are, but it's like, put it this way, it is like, it's not like gears on the car, but you just, it's like manual. The gate is just about to open. And then I'm going to take you to the front of the boat. But as you can't see the front of the boat, you don't know how far. Back to the next one. Think of that then? I came around very slowly, didn't I?
Perfect timing.
I didn't want to come down too fast. So I think, oh, I'd have to stop.
Do you want your camera back?
What?
Do you want your thing back?
Oh, yeah, I can get it. Where are we stopping, top or bottom?
Say it again.
Where are we stopping?
You want you to stop at the top?
I don't mind.
Well, it'd be too early when I'm eating lunch.
Yeah, we have to.
And it's
vegan. Now we'll walk back to the bow. That means it's stern. That's your stern. Oh yeah. You don't have them. gates are opening.
Oh, we're going back.
Forward. So, at the back is a fountain of water. Well, one water land. Not a very deep lock. Nice. A little heaven in that film. Nice towpath is there. More in that valley. More there. Now it's just the bottom of the fall. About 5 to 10 minutes from where we are now before that. So here is the winding hole, just coming up to our left. So you put the front by the bow, as it's called. up to them by the nose, if you want to call it a nose, you can. Quite a long nose on this boat. I am hoping to do a boat tour, maybe at some point in the future. So the you'll turn a hard slow left, and then it's quite a hard reverse. Wow. You will have to see in a bit, but I've got to come back round by enough that I've got reversing into the mooring spot. So you're putting the nose in the bow, putting the bow into the wind. Oh, and you swing it around the tiller. Quite a nice wind in our last one, quite big. Heading towards the forelocks. In barely quick succession. That's where we're stopping for dinner. We might have to blast the horn before. This is called the house. So if you look to the left, that is Greenshaw's Lane. To the right, I mean, not left. So there is a dog on the towpath. Three dogs. Dogs. nearly there now. So this bridge we just went through, I think it leads about half a mile. The miles, I'm not entirely sure. Fairly tight turn. Right. We are just coming to the four. This is around the bend. Never been on the canal before, you think the canal would be narrow, but this does feel like a section of the river. But it is still canal. Quite a bit of wide open space canal, but it does feel like the river. Well, I think that's how it's all silted. I'm not sure about that. Right. But there is a heron. Let's see if we can get a shot of him. Oh, will he fly? Oh, he just flew away. A few meters down the canal and then we'll see him again. Turns out this bird wants to come with us all the way. There's a bike coming. But I'm only naming Bob. And he looked at me when I was going to Bob. I think he gave up with that. Back on the cruise in. We're nearly there now, I think. It's just... I'm hoping it's just around the corner, but... But I know the next bridge we don't go under. For this stuff, then we'll start with joint. Well, we will be joining the Starbridge arm. Now, I will show you the Starbridge. Bit of a narrow bit here. The canal is a little bit down, but only about, not by much, or 10 inch. It's just because of the nice weather, but today I have got my coat on. Because it's cold, wet. It's a very breezy, it was earlier on, but... been turning out to be a nice video for you to watch. So we're just going over a little stream where we saw the sheep, which is on the left, on the side. And then we are. There's some sheep for you. And then we've got the... I think the stream lead goes all the way up there and then it comes to us on the left hand side. And I think it's a stream. gonna make it round. Not making it round. What do you think of that? Lily got. Lily just got stuck by a thing. Let's just say it. Think he just got stuck. So we are at the forelock. That stretch for the four, and then we'll do the forelock, and then we're stopping for dinner. And the engine can have a rest as well, and it can have a nap. And there's, I think it's a river. Oh, so you can't sail on that. Last time we did stop down here and we got, well, deserted. We got absolutely stuck. And I think it's all, well, cool. I think it does. So the port is just on our left, so if you carry on, I think it takes you to London. I'm not entirely sure. And if you go on the River Severn, but we're not doing that. I definitely are going to do that today. We're going to four locks back to our mooring. It's gonna be a shop. Yeah, go under this bridge, I'll bite. Plenty of throat. Four locks in fairly quick succession. Look, and we'll have to reverse. We're gonna make it round. I didn't have to reverse. No, I'm shaking now though. Into the four locks. I'm gonna put the camera at the front in a minute. We're in the lock. One out of four. God. Down there, we've just come from. Now we're heading up there. In barely quick succession. So this is the second lot, so two more to do and we actually three more to do and then we're done. The next one is just a little bit round the corner. Because the more I don't think I've seen a bike come down, we should be fine. Today, I'm just gonna hold on to the forward gear because if we back, I tend to go when the gutter wolf comes, you stick it forward. These locks are very fairly deep. So, well then. I think the gates are a bit broken. People have crashed. And there's all the water. So you might think when the overflow goes down the bank down over there. Over there. So it's still another, say, 4 inches to... come up. These locks are quite deep. If you are coming this way, you'll know. And there's people coming on. And there's a boat coming up, which is just got stuck, I think. It's stuck on the silt. Going through the front of the boat. As you can see, this pound we're in now is actually, approximately, really is low. It's actually... I am absolutely knackered. Nah. Part of the people who work for this canal, then really is low this. So like somebody's been stealing some water out of here. I don't know why, but yeah, it is low. So into the lock. So I think it's the third in the bunch. I'm not entirely sure. And this is the lock we have to pour it because there's loads of rubbish in it. I think. I can't exactly remember, but I think there is a load of rubbish in this lock. Of rubbish in the lock. Look at all this. So I'm gonna let this play in real time. And this lock is quite deep. So the whole floor is quite deep. So you might be wondering, why is that step? Think of that front, so... okay. I don't think this lock seems to be barely dry. This lock. See how much rubbish. Right. I'll jump off and show you the bow in a minute. It's the lock. Still filling. Down here. And there's the bow of the boat. Where you can sit and film. But jump back on because we'll be going in a minute. And this is where the A449 is. Just around here. There's the engine. In that. That's the A449 just over that bridge. We've just been under it. Low here as well. It's really low, these four. But hopefully, I've even got some sun coming. This will be a very nice place. Wow. I wouldn't like to even. We're heading in to the next lock. I'm not sure if this is last of the bunch while I've been counting. Now let's talk about ducks. So I've just gone in the way of the boat. I'm not sure if this is the last lock. Just the last lock. Last lock. Last lock. Got one more lock, haven't we?
That's it.
And then we've got three at the 16.
Five.
Five? Ah, two. Three?
Well, we're having our dinner, are we? Stopping.
Yeah. Are you going to come back on and get the rope? Pardon? Are you going to be back on and get the rope?
I'll get the rope. I'll come to the gate. And then I'll get the rope.
I'll get the back end.
We'll moor just past the lock landing.
Yeah, no, we normally do.
Yeah. And then we can have our lunch. Do you want some soup?
Nah, I'm alright.
Exactly.
Yeah. Can we do that to you, can't we? Do you think of the last lock? Of the day? Well, not of the day. Well, off this vlog, anyway. Top lock of the four, last lock. And there's the A449 over there. I think that's the Vex over there. So, if you know them ladders, so if you're single handed, you'd have to go up them ladders. But what a nice garden this people have got. And then, that's the name of the lock. And the bab. So mooring up here, I will show you how to moor. So we're going to call it a vlog, so hope you've enjoyed it. Thank you for watching. Bye for now.